So you decided to buy the Tesup wind turbine to save money and protect nature. But can Tesup's most advanced vertical wind turbine produce even 10% of what they promise? Tesup markets their Atlas vertical wind turbine as a 10-kilowatt power generator capable of meeting household electricity needs. However, examining the physical dimensions and applying wind energy calculations reveals significant discrepancies. Based on the original Atlas X7 model dimensions, which are 790 millimeters by 460 millimeters, the swept area is approximately 0.36 square meters. Using the wind power formula and an unusually high wind speed of 16 meters per second, which is well above typical residential wind conditions, the available wind power equals 900 watts. Let's not forget that this is the maximum theoretical wind power available. However, there's a natural limit called the Betz limit, which means no wind turbine can capture more than 59.3% of the wind's energy. Vertical turbines like the Savonius type are usually less efficient than horizontal ones. In perfect conditions, they reach about 25% efficiency, but in real use, it's often less than 10%. But let's go further and use 25% in our calculations. An actual output power would be 900 watts multiplied by 0.25, which gives 225 watts of power. Let's find out how many kilowatt hours we get in one day with this strong constant wind of 16 meters per second. With the previously calculated 225 watts of energy, we multiply by 24 hours and get 5,400 watts or 5.4 kilowatt hours per day. But in the brochure provided with the Atlas X7 model, they promise 7 kilowatts per hour. This means the reality is only 3.2% of the promised output. Let's go further and find out if it's even possible to reach 7 kilowatt hours with the Tesup wind turbine. This output would be reached at 825 RPM on Tesup's 10kW generator, using data from their own brochure. What wind speed is required to achieve this? Using physics formulas, we get 31.1 meters per second. That is 112 kilometers per hour, or 69.5 miles per hour. That's a really strong hurricane. And even the user manual advises covering the wind turbine blades with a cover in such severe weather conditions. Things get even worse when I read reviews on Trustpilot. Here's one of almost 500 bad reviews. Bought a new vertical turbine. It arrived, had it professionally wired. It's absolutely useless. Won't spin in 40 miles per hour storm winds. This is incapable of delivering 10 kilowatts as advertised. Scam. And Tesup's problem isn't just lying about having a good wind turbine. They often don't even deliver the products to customers. They just take the money and keep feeding people promises that it will be delivered soon. Some customers waited more than 7 months and received nothing. Tesup's vertical wind turbines cannot produce even 3% of their promised output under normal operating conditions. Physics-based calculations show that even under extreme wind conditions, the actual power output is far below the specifications. This dramatic overstatement of performance, combined with the fundamental limitations of small, vertical access wind turbines, makes these products unsuitable for serious renewable energy applications, despite their marketing claims. But the final nail in the coffin is the poor service of this company. If so many people on Trustpilot were scammed by this shop, I don't think you should have any doubts about whether it's worth buying this wind turbine for your home. If someone has experience with this company, please share it in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video to get fresh updates about renewable energy for your home.